Last week we described the surface of the person and introduced the Holy Spirit.
上周讲到说我们就要介绍这个圣灵。
The Holy Spirit representing the lampstand, menorah in Hebrew.
圣灵它代表在希伯来书里面讲的那个灯台。
Which has to do with the seven branches.
这个灯台有七个分支。
And the seven fire of God.
有神的七火。
Seven in one.
就是七个。
Just like the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit are three in one.
就好像圣父、圣子、圣灵是合而为一。
It is not seven other spirits.
所以它。
But there are seven spirits in one.
所以它不是分开的，而是这七灵合而为一。
The symbol is the lampstand.
所以这个象征，这个代表就是灯台。
They are representing the seven churches. The seven feasts of the Lord. The seven spirits of God. And the seven mountains of the world. Which has to do with the family, education, government, religion, family, arts, and entertainment.
这个就是社会七山七大领域，就是家庭、教育、这个教会、媒体等等七个领域，大家知道是吧？社会七山呢？
So John the Apostle saw Jesus Christ on the island of Patmos. John the Apostle.
就是这个使徒约翰。 他看就是在灵里面得着启示。
And in Revelation chapter 5 verse 6 it says, And I looked, and John was looking, and behold, in the midst of the throne, and on the four living, were four living creatures, and in the midst of the elders stood a lamb as though it was, has been slain, having seven horns, horns talk about power, and seven eyes, which are the seven spirits of God, sent out into all the earth.
启示录五章六节，我又看见宝座与四活物，并长老之中有羔羊站立，像是被杀过的，有七角七眼。这个角就代表能力，就是神的七灵奉差遣往普天下去的。
Yes, so we will touch one of them that the seven spirits of God, called it the spirit of wisdom.
所以今天我们主要讲神的七灵的其中一个灵，就是智慧的灵。We
mentioned already last week that Jesus Christ, when he has said, the spirit of the Lord is upon me, that was the full expression of the full capacity of the lampstand seven spirits of God was resting upon.
就上周我们讲到耶稣说，主耶和华的灵在我身上，就是讲到神的七灯台。Whether
you were baptized, whether you repent of your sins, whether you were born again, you were baptized with water into repentance, but Jesus immersed you with the Holy Spirit and fire.
那就是你受洗的话是这个悔改的洗礼，还有就是但耶稣他是有水的洗礼，也有圣灵火的洗礼。So
while Jesus immersed you in the Holy Spirit, he immersed you with the sevenfold spirit.
所以当圣灵来去给你火的洗礼的时候，那你就是被神的七灵来洗礼。And
it takes the growth of process and discipline and yielding to the Holy Spirit until you grew and mature to the full measure of Christ.
那当你不断地去顺服神，不断地去成长成熟的时候，也就慢慢地能够完全地去彰显出来这个神的七灵，就是耶稣基督的灵。There
are hundreds of scriptures talk about the Spirit of the Lord. Rest upon me or the Holy Spirit move me.
在圣经里面有几百
Or the Holy Spirit come upon me.
讲到神的灵在我身上。
Like under the old covenant, the Holy Spirit was coming upon the prophets.
那在旧约里面，神的灵是临到那些先知的身上。
And God's people that they were able to do great exploit for the kingdom of God.
以至于这些人，他可以为了神的国去做伟大的事情。
But under the greater covenant, the new covenant, the Holy Ghost is dwelling within us, 24 on. Is your personal GPS. That guiding you and instructing you to make a right decision. So that later on the consequences will be good for right decision. So the sevenfold spirit was resting upon Jesus. And now he says the spirit of the Lord is resting upon me.
所以他讲到说主耶和华的灵在我身上。
Amen. Can you say the Spirit of the Lord resting upon me?
所以你可以说出来说主耶和华的灵在我身上。
Can you confess with belief? Strong that you believe actually.
你可以带着信心然后来去宣告。
Proclamation agree with the word of God.
所以要有这样的一个信心,
the Spirit of the Lord is upon me.
然后就要说主的灵在我身上，带着信心和相信啊。
Can I say again? The Spirit of the Lord is upon me.
主的灵在我身上。主的灵在我身上。在我身上。上上。
Amen. Now the Lord is the Spirit, and when the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty.
主就是那灵，主的灵在哪里，哪里就有自由。
In other words, when you who are full of the Holy Spirit, when you come into the situation where people are so confused, they don't know what to do.
就是说当你被主的灵充满的时候，你去面对一些情况，有一些人，那些人都非常的困惑，不知道该怎么。
People in troubles through sickness or disease or confusion, or they don't know what is the future.
就是说那些人充满了困惑，然后面对困难。
Or they don't have any hope.
或者生病，不知道该怎么办，或者没有盼望。
Or they don't see, they don't hear God.
对未来感到很茫茫，看不见神，听不见神，所有一切都是很黑暗的。
And the Spirit of the Lord is upon you. Therefore, when you are in this situation, there is a liberty. There is freedom. There is understanding.
就有聪明, 然后那些人就能够得着聪明。
This week,
所以这周,
I have a different relationship with different people who are involved in marketplace.
就我和那些在市场的那些人，他们有一些关系。啊，就是那些人，他们是做生意的。
And they believe for greater, bigger businesses.
他们相信他们的生意可以做得更好。For
years, but doesn't come.
虽然就是说相信了很多年，可是生意还没有。
Year passing by, years passing by, doesn't come.
就是说有这个期待，可是这么多年了还没有到来。But
the revelation come.
但是启示来了。
All I need is a spirit of wisdom because I am unmature to handling such a big business.
那比如说像说，哎，我没有办法去管理这么大的生意，可是，所以我需要神的这个智慧，智慧的灵。
So it's about the stewardship.
所以这个智慧的灵，它指的是管理和经营。
And that was the revelation of that person that says to me, I need the wisdom of God.
所以说我有这样个人的一个启示，就是我觉得我需要神的智慧。
So that I can handle what God is giving to me.
所以这样我就可以去处理神所赐给我的一切。
It will not be like in the past spoiled.
It's not be like the past.
Like in the past that it will be spoiled.
不会像过去那些就是被荒废。
Or misinvest.
或是这种投资不当
or putting into the ground that is stony.
Stony?
Stony ground, like full of stones.
或者是这个种子撒在就全都是那些的石头地上。
Have to know the fertilized ground. Have to know the fertilized ground. Good ground, good soil. So the purpose of the spirit of wisdom for the believer is to rightfully position us with God.
所以这个智慧的灵会帮助信徒能够去与神对齐，站在对的位置。
So that we can be rightful channel for making right decision towards God.
所以我们就能够去向神来去做正确的选择。
And producing wealth.
并且我们可以产出。
In the church, we are really afraid of that war wealth because it has been abused in the past with different movements.
就是带来富足和财富，然后在教会我们都比较害怕这个财富，因为财富在过去教会历史当中被
First John says that, beloved, I wish that you prosper and be in good health, even as your soul prospers.
在约翰一书里面有讲到说，我希望你的这个灵魂凡事兴盛，对，包括你的财务。
So God wants us to prosper and be wealthy in our divine health, to walk in divine health.
所以呢，神希望我们是这个有这种属天的健康。
Which is better than divine healing.
那就是有这种超自然的医治。
To be healthy is very wealthy.
那我们如果身体健康，其实你就非常的富足。
Yes. And to be healthy in our minds.
还有就是你的思想富足。
And to be positive.
就是你的思维是积极的，乐观的。
That's the wealth.
这就是你的财富。
Also financially.
那还有这个属神的特征属性和。
To know what to do.
就是这个神的智慧指的就是你,
and to know what to do next.
你知道该怎么做,
so that we can be prepared.
以至于我们可以提前预备,
not only for the coming of the Lord Jesus,
不是预备主再来,
but we preparing for his move of the Holy Spirit. We were singing the song. It starts from the brook.
所以就是不是预备主再来,
the movement starts from the brook, from the water cup to the river and to the ocean.
这个神的运行是从一个小的溪流, brook is the, a stream of water.
Yes,
从一个小的溪流, 然后再到这个,
until
这个生命河水, 然后来去聚集起来, 然后直到海洋,
and the ocean is supplying vast wealth of water to all the continents.
然后这个洋海的水, 它供应所有大洲的这个需要。
The water is life.
所以水是活的。
More than 75% in our body is water.
那我们人的身体75%。
And the Holy Spirit is moving, was hovering over the water in Genesis 1:2.
在创世纪1章2节讲到, 神的灵运行在水面上。
So let us look into different aspects and facets of wisdom, the spirit of wisdom.
现在来具体看一下这个智慧的灵的不同的面相。
If you can imagine diamond,
你现在来想象一下一个钻石,
55, 56 facets,
有55或56个这种的切面。
It is like the spirit of wisdom.
那这个就是像智慧的灵一样。
Everyone is precious.
对，每一个切面都是非常宝贵的。
Every facet representing some different aspects.
每一个切面都代表了一个不同，有不同的含义。
One of those facets is the spirit of wisdom help us to understand the visions and dream and interpret them.
其中一个圣智慧的灵，它的一个切面，它的意思就是它可以帮助我们去了解、明白、解释意象和异梦。
How many of you know the story of Joseph?
你们谁知道这个约瑟的故事？
Have you read Joseph in Genesis?
有读过创世纪的约瑟的故事吗？
There is the most chapters in Genesis is devoted to Joseph's life.
所以其实在创世纪大部分的这种篇章讲的都是约瑟的一生。
Joseph is good representing for us the picture of Jesus.
所以约瑟他的从约瑟的故事可以去能够看到，就他是其实是代表了耶稣。
I don't have time to go into the details of Joseph's life. I just give you the aspect of spirit of wisdom in the life of Joseph.
就是透过约瑟的故事来去告诉你智慧的灵。
So Joseph had that spirit of wisdom in his life.
对，因为约瑟他有智慧的灵在。
From the childhood.
就从他小的时候。
He could see the future when he was a small little boy.
就在他是个小孩的时候，他就能够去看见未来。
He could see the visions of the future.
他能够去预见未来，因为他。
And he told his brothers.
然后他就。 And
he does his fathers and the community, and he was telling everybody.
告诉他的弟兄姐妹,
he thought everybody would be happy with him that he received the vision of the future. And he was having interpretations.
然后并且他也有这种解释,
his brothers didn't like those interpretations. But years later, it came to pass.
但是很多年以后, 他的异梦却,
so Joseph was discerning and was able to handle successful the situations and prophecies.
所以呢, 关于这些的预言, 约瑟他能够解释并且他能够去 管理, 处理那些各种各样的情况和困境,
and give the meaning of all the interpretations.
并且还能够去解释这个含义。
When two servants of Pharaoh, Pharaoh was caught and put into the prison.
就是法老有两个这个官长吧，仆人，然后被抓到监牢。
They were both discouraged. And Joseph had interpretation of the dream. You read about Genesis chapter 40.
He interpreted their dreams. Yes.
And each of those servants had a dream, and there was no interpretation. So Joseph saying, do not interpretation belongs to God, tell them to me, please.
然后他就说这个解释难道不是从神来的吗？所以呢，你告诉他们来找我。
So he received this interpretation.
所以,
and he tell them.
所以约瑟他,
in after 3 days, Pharaoh will have a feast. He will lift up your head. One will be restored, and one will be killed.
所以约瑟他是有解释异梦的这个能力的，那大概过了几天以后，他这两个仆人一个被官复原职，一个被杀了。And
it came to pass.
然后他所说的就是后来发生的事情，就按照他所解释的去应验。
And the next time, his friends forgot about this.
然后后来呢，他的那个朋友就。Then
the chapter later, Pharaoh himself, God never forgets you. The man may forget the promise, but God will never forget you.
那个人把他忘了以后，但是神他不会忘记你。
The man may promise you something.
Sorry，人会忘记你，但神不会忘记你。
The man may, human may promise you something, but they can never deliver. But God promise and bring it to pass.
可能人他会去给你做，就是兑现承诺一些事情，但也许人做不到。可是神对你的应许，神是可以成就的。
That was in the life of Joseph. That was in the life of Joseph. So this time Pharaoh had a dream and no one able to interpret it.
所以那个人把约瑟忘了以后，现在是法老有一个异梦，但没有人可以解释，所以约瑟的机会就来了。Then
one of those servants whose interpretation was correctly interpreted and he was restored to Pharaoh, he mentioned that there is a man in your kingdom whose name is Joseph who have the ability to interpret dreams.
所以那个官复原职的那个人呢，他就想起了约瑟，所以他就和法老来推荐约瑟。So
Joseph was called and he interpreted this vision for Egypt.
所以约瑟就被提到法老面前去为法老解梦。
And the most powerful man confessed with his mouth, can we find such as this, as one as this, a man in whom is the Spirit of God.
在启示录41章38节里面，法老就说，我们能找到有谁能像这个人呢？在他里面有神的灵。
So that is why we need the Spirit of wisdom in our lives.
所以这个意思就是说，我们需要智慧的灵在我们的生命当中。
Like last night, we do have a worship. One of our sisters have a dream about the Chinese church.
Last night, 昨晚我们在敬拜当中有一个姐妹，她做了一个异梦。
And that was interpretation.
然后呢，她也做了一个解释。
To the Chinese church.
就是有做了一个异梦，并且解梦，并且有一个应用，就是关于中国教会的。
Okay, the second aspect of the Spirit of wisdom is to apply justice and judgment to the situation.
第二个智慧的灵，它的好处就是说，对于不同的环境，可以去应用正义和判断或者审判。
In other words, man, human look in the appearance.
意思就是说人是看外貌看表象
into the packages how beautiful the package is
就比如说那个你包装盒哎呀真的很漂亮
but God is looking inside of that package
可是神他是看内在看里面
and give justice
并且神给就是给给予这个
so the spirit of wisdom
正义
The spirit of wisdom enables you to make right judgment and justice.
所以就是智慧的灵能够帮助你去对于不同的环境做出一个公义正义的判断或者审判。
King Solomon had that opportunity to exercise that spirit.
所罗门王他就有机会来去做这样的一个正义的这个判断。
To give wise judgment.
就是他的这个判断是有智慧的。
Let's pray for our judges of our lands and nations that God will fill them with the spirit of wisdom that they make a right judgment.
所以让我们为我们这个地区的这个法院，然后那些的法官们，然后他们充满了神智慧的灵，以至于他们所做的审判都是公义的，是正义的。
In the First Kings chapter 3, Solomon judging wisely two women.
就这个所罗门王，然后他做的这公正的审判，就是那个。妇女她的孩子死了
there was a baby.
孩子死了然后到底这个孩子是谁的然后所罗门做了一个有智慧的判断
Both have babies.
这两个妇女都有孩子
and one was accidentally killed her own baby while
其中一个
ignorantly killed her baby
其中一个是意外把她的孩子压死了
and he won by unjustly matters Steal someone else's baby.
所以他就想把另一个妇女的孩子给抢过来。
So Solomon were able to bring the situation into the conclusion of the right justice.
所以所罗门王他就能够去面对这样的一个情况，可以做出一个公义的审判。
And give right judgment.
而并且也是一个正确的审判。
With the spirit of wisdom.
因为他有这个智慧的灵在他里面。
Then the next aspect of that spirit of wisdom you can find in the building of the tabernacle of Moses.
下一个关于智慧的灵的一个层面就是你可以在这个摩西去建造神的会幕的时候，可以看到智慧的灵是如何来。
It is the heart of our Father which is in heaven to have relationship with His children and to dwell among us.
我们的天父是渴望住在他的孩子当中，可是我们作为人有罪，然后有各种的问题，所以呢，拦阻神没有办法在我们当中。
So God desired to build a tabernacle.
所以呢，为了要住在人间，住在人当中，所以神呢，让摩西去建造摩西会幕。
Then God can come and dwell among His people.
以至于神可以住在他的百姓当中。
Then He can speak to His people face to face.
然后他就可以面对面跟百姓说话。
He can reveal His will, His purpose, and His plan.To the children of Israel.
然后他就可以和以色列的这些孩子们去显明启示他的旨意、他的计划。
So Abba Fu decided to build a tabernacle.
所以我们的阿巴父他想要建造一个会幕。
And he gives specific requirements to Moses how to build.
所以他给摩西说的很清楚，告诉摩西具体要怎么建造会幕。
And the children of Israel, they were slaves for 400 years. They don't know how to have the skills of building new things in the for the Lord.
那但是以色列百姓他们在埃及已经被奴役400年，所以他们出来以后并没有什么技能，说是要去就是有建造的技能，或者是去创造的技能。
So God filled the two men call it.Bezalel and Aholiabah with the spirit of wisdom and giving them education, supernatural education, how to develop those skills and knowledge, how to craft with their own hands.The Ark of the Covenant.
对，就在出埃及记三十六章一节里面就有讲到，就是神的这个智慧的灵充满，就是那个建造会幕的工匠，就是比撒列和亚和利亚伯，以至于他们有这样的知识，然后知道怎么去建造会幕。
How to make a lampstand, a menorah?
建造这个七灯台。
It's fascinating that even up to today, there is no man in the world full of the spirit of wisdom that is able to build a menorah out of one piece of gold.
就是这个是非常神奇的，即便现在。 如果有某个就是即便某个人他被神的灵充满他也没有办法去建造这个七灯台
So practically when you are filled with the Holy Spirit you are facing decisions and matters that you don't have skills you don't have abilities
就是说当你就是面对一些情况你没有技能也没有能力不知道该怎么去解决和处理的时候
But God supernaturally filling with the spirit of wisdom suddenly you know how to do it
但是当神智慧的灵充满你的时候你突然就知道该怎么做
With the spirit of excellency even though you didn't do it before You didn't do it before Even though you didn't do it before
就哪怕你以前从来没学过也从来没做过可是智慧的灵充满你你就瞬间你就会了
That was the case of Bezalel and Aholiah.
所以就这里面这个比撒列和亚哥利亚。
And Bezalel and Aholiah, and every gifted artist in which the Lord has put wisdom and understanding, those two things, usually wisdom and understanding, they are parts, twins.
就是这个，他们是被智慧的灵充满，同时他不只是有智慧，他也有聪明。这个聪明就是一种理解力。
And the purpose is to know how.
这个智慧的灵充满他们的目的是使他们知道该如何怎么办。
To know how to do all matters of war for the service of the sanctuary shall do according to all that the Lord has commanded.
这个我找一下这个经文啊，出埃及记三十六章一节，里面讲了比撒列和雅各利亚伯，并一切心里有智慧的，就是蒙耶和华赐智慧聪明，叫他知道做圣所各样使用之功的，都要照耶和华所吩咐的做工。
It's just like we have the word of God, we have a knowledge of the word of God, but we have to understand and have the revelation how to do the word of God. How to do the word of God.
就是说当我们学了这个神的话语但是知道神的话语并且说我们也领受了启示并且我们也知道如何来应用。
Since Jesus commissioned us to go and preach the kingdom of God,
所以耶稣他差派我们去传讲天国的道。
We have to know how to preach the kingdom.
现在我们就是要面临的是，我们要知道如何去传讲。
And we have to know to whom we preach the kingdom of God.
我们也要知道向谁传讲。
If we preach to Chinese, we need to know how to preach to Chinese to make them. Understandable that the Chinese can grasp the message of the kingdom of God with the Chinese clothing.
就如果我们向中国的弟兄姐妹来去传讲耶稣，我们要知道如何向中国人传讲，以至于他们能够去抓住这个信息，能够得着。
And while we are preaching to the Indians, we have to know how to preach to the Indians that makes them Indians clothing.
就如果我们向印度人去传道的话，那要去专门说针对印度人，他如何能够明白？就好像是，他 cloth，
yeah cloth or
就好像这个
the packages the bucket
就是我们讲的道，然后这个外表是印度人可以接受的，然后呢
？And when we're preaching to the Jewish people, we have to know how to present how to preach to the Jews.
如果向犹太人去讲传道的话，就要去想。如何才能够去使犹太人能够接收到这个
？That none of our words will fall to the ground empty，
以至于我们所传讲的不会去说是白讲了，或者是就是空话。
There are many preaching is going around but falling to the ground。
你知道有很多的这种讲道传讲，可是都是空的，没有果效。
Heal the sick， and he says heal the sick。
耶稣说你要去这个给病人按手祷告。
How to heal the sick？
那现在的问题是你要如何来
？That is why the spirit of wisdom enable us to know how to heal the sick。
所以讲到如何，那就是智慧的灵就会去告诉你如何医治病人。
Casting out devils。How to cast devils?
耶稣讲到说要去赶鬼，那现在的问题是你要如何赶鬼
？Raise the dead. How shall we raise the dead?
使死人复活，那如何叫死人复活呢
？Doing great exploit for the Lord.
所以就是要去
building company. building family, building the congregation, building the project of the kingdom of God, building the agricultural farms, explore the kingdom of God. How? We have to ask for the spirit of wisdom to enable us how to do those exploits. How to do what we are called in the kingdom of God. This is what's happened with the spirit of wisdom. That is why we need the spirit of wisdom. There were four men in the mighty Babylonian Empire. His name is Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, and Daniel. The spirit of wisdom was resting in on those four men.
主的灵在那四个年轻人身上。
When the spirit of wisdom was resting upon you, you would have an audience with the king.
You will have
audience with the king.
就是当你有这个神的灵的话，就是你就能够去面见君王。
Just like Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, and Daniel, and Joseph, and Jesus above all.
就好像是约瑟一样，他是去面对法老，然后这四个年轻人，他们面对的是尼布甲尼撒王。
So as for those four men, the young men, God gave them knowledge and skill. You see, skills. Wisdom is a skill in literature, in wisdom. And Daniel has understanding in all visions and dreams.
就但以理书一章十七节，这四个少年人神在各样文字学问，这个学问原文是智慧上赐给他们聪明知识，但以理又明白各样的异象梦兆。
In other words, the spirit of wisdom rests in greater measure in Daniel than his companion.
意思就是说，这个智慧的灵借着但以理有一个更大的彰显。
Because he loved righteousness and hated sin, therefore God anointed him with the oil of gladness more than his companions.
所以因为但以理他恨恶罪恶，喜悦公义，所以神就去更多的来去膏抹他。
So Daniel continually in the Babylon for 70 years.
70 years.
The empire was rising up and falling down. The kingdom was rising and falling down. But Daniel was keep on going, from generation to generation, from strength to strength, from glory to glory, with the spirit of wisdom. Hallelujah. Glory to God. We need Daniels today in Jesus Christ's name.
Amen. 所以这个国度的君王起起落落，然后但是但以理他因为有智慧的灵，所以他一直都是来去彰显神的荣耀。God
raised up a Daniel in the king's palace.
所以神在这个王宫来兴起但以理。God
raised up Daniel in the government offices.
所以神在这个政要的领域，在政府领域兴起但以理。Who
will disciple the nations?
所以但以理可以去门训万国。In
Jesus Christ's name.
在耶稣基督里。Amen. Amen.
So this is what we must arise.
所以我们必须要兴起。Arise. 我们要兴起。Arise.
How can we arise?
我们要如何兴起？
How can we shine?
我们如何发光？
We have to align ourselves because it is the Holy Ghost that calls us to arise.
所以我们必须要与神对齐，因为圣灵呼召我们要兴起。
We must yield to the Holy Spirit to raise us up.
所以我们必须要降服于圣灵，以至于我们被兴起。
Strengthen our spirit man.
来去坚固我们里面的灵人。
Fill us with the spirit of wisdom.
使我们充满了智慧的灵
and understanding
和聪明。
They are together. You see, spirit of wisdom and understanding all throughout the scriptures, they are together.
所以圣经里面讲到
，It's like a left hand right hand, wisdom, understanding the left.
圣经里面讲到智慧的灵的时候，聪明跟他是一起的， 所以智慧和聪明的灵就像你的左手和右手一样。
In the book of Revelation, talk about revelation, it means understanding, unveiling.
所以在启示录里面讲到这个启示，其实这个启示就是聪明、理解、明白。
That you are full of wisdom and revelation, understanding, unveiling things to the matters that you understand now.
当你有这种智慧、聪明的灵，还有启示，就当你面对各种各样的环境，你就能够明白为什么。
So you read about that in Daniel chapter 5. Daniel chapter 5. In your homework.
五章，给你今天的作业，但以理书五章。
And you pray that God will continually fill you with the Spirit of wisdom.
所以你要来向神祷告，来去使神的灵不断的充满你。
The other aspect of the Spirit of wisdom is to have the skills for war. For warfare.
另外一个智慧灵的这个面向指的是善于征战。
The Bible says what? That we don't fight against the flesh and blood.
圣经说我们征战不是属血气，
but against the principality and the power of the darkness.
而是与这种的天空属灵气的恶魔征战。
How can we touch him, my and talent for Jesus?
How can
we take him, my and how can we take talent for Jesus?
我们如何来去为耶稣得着泰国得着清迈？
How can we take China for Jesus?
我们如何来去为了耶稣得着？
How can we make Asia the nation of Israel, Middle East for Jesus?
我们如何为了耶稣去得着亚洲，得着以色列？
This is how.
现在的问题是如何？
Joshua was filled with the Spirit of wisdom.
约书亚就是被智慧的灵充满。
Moses, his pastor, was his pastor for 40 years.
40 years. 摩西是约书亚的这个牧者，然后四十年。
Joshua has to feed some big shoes.
耶稣亚的鞋是很大的。
Joshua was a follower of Moses.
耶稣亚他是跟随摩西的。
And Moses was called a great deliverer of Israel.
摩西被称为这个释放这个以色列的人。
Moses could face Pharaoh with all the army of hosts.
摩西他能够面对法老和法老所有的军队。
Moses can face the Red Sea.
摩西他能够面对红海。
And the army behind him.
并且在后面有追兵追着他们。
And overcome and have the breakthrough.
但他能够胜过。
And walk into the other side.
并且他们能够穿过红海得胜。
So the spirit of wisdom is coming through laying of hands as well. The spirit of wisdom is coming through laying on hands.
所以如果就是智慧的灵，你要得着智慧的灵的一个方式是通过按手祷告也可以得着。
In the Jordan River, when John was baptizing Jesus, the Bible says that he immersed him when he was rising up from the water, the Spirit of God rested on Jesus.
在约翰河里面，这个约翰给耶稣施洗的时候，当耶稣从水里上来，然后神的灵就像鸽子一样降在耶稣身上。
In the day of Pentecost, the 120 were endued with the Spirit of the Lord.
在五旬节的时候，那120个人他们也是领受了主的灵。
So Joshua was filled with the spirit of wisdom.
所以约书亚他也是充满了智慧的灵。
He has to become military leader.
因为他必须成为这个军队的领袖。
He has to face the war.
他要面对征战。
He had to fight many wars.
他要去打各种各样的战。
He had to conquer the promised land.
他要去得着那个应许之地。
The promise was given to him, but it would not be given cheap. It has to be obtained by war, fighting.
这个应许之地要如何得着，必须要通过征战得着。
Now Joshua, the son of Nun.
约书亚是这个
son of Nun.
Nun.
Nothing. Son of nothing.
Son,
So if you don't have good name, don't worry about that anymore. If you don't obtain good name, don't worry about that.
如果你的名字有很好的名字，就不要担心。
Joshua didn't have good name. He was a son of nothing.
啊，就是约书亚的名字并不是很好，因为这个难就是啥也什么也不是，所以他是什么也不是的儿子。
Because when you are in Christ, you obtain His name.
对，因为你在基督里，你所领受的是他的名字。
So the Bible says, now Joshua the son of Nun was full of the spirit of wisdom.For Moses has laid his hands on him, so that the children of Israel hid him, and did as the Lord commanded Moses.
生命记三十四章九节，嫩的儿子，这个嫩他说是啊，理解为说什么也不是哈。嫩的儿子约书亚，因为摩西曾按手在他头上，就被智慧的灵充满，以色列人便听从他，照着耶和华吩咐摩西的行了。
And this principle you can find throughout the Bible. You can see Elijah and Elisha as well. Double portion.
这种按手来去传递智慧的灵的方式，在圣经其他地方也可以看到。比如说，以利亚为以利沙按手祷告。
You can see more. Paul the apostle to Timothy, young man, laid his hands upon him. The Spirit of God came upon him.
保罗为提摩太来按手祷告，然后主的灵降在他身上。
And he started with a greater measure.
对，就是一开始 start with a greater measure.
Yes.
就是直接是按手祷告传递嘛，他们就得着这个。
And you study the life and all the wars that Joshua after that fight He fought all the wars and won, except the one Ai war that the children of Israel steal some stuff, take some stuff that was not allowed. We know the story.
就是这个约书亚后来他打赢了所有的战争，除了有一场战没有打赢，就是那个爱场是吗？
So he know how to warfare and win all the wars, all the battles, and give to the 12 tribes of Israel all the inheritance.
对。所以呢，约书亚他能够靠着神对他的带领，打赢了所有的仗，并且把这个应许之地分给以色列的支派。
So the spirit of wisdom will enable you to know what is your inheritance.
所以智慧的灵，它能够让你知道你的产业是什么。
And where is your inheritance?
那你的产业在哪里？
So you don't have to be jealous of one another.
所以你不需要嫉妒别人。
You don't have to bad wish to one another.
你也不需要去祈求别人。
Because there is a place for everybody in the kingdom of God.
因为在神的国里，每个人都有自己的产业。
Then in the life of Jesus, this man Jesus, the Son of the Living God, was full of the Spirit of wisdom. You always know what to do.
因为
I got short story because of the time. Yes.
因为耶稣他充满了神的灵，所以他总是知道该做什么。
In Matthew 17:24-27, there was a story about paying the tax. The someone asking Peter, Simon Peter, do you master paying tax or no?
就马太福音十七章二十四到二十七节，就是讲到这个赋税的这个故事。
Then Jesus knew his thoughts. Jesus always know our thoughts.
然后这个就是收税的彼得就问说，哎，你们要不要你们的先生不纳税吗？怎么？然后耶稣。
And he asked him a question.
然后耶稣明白他们的思想，然后耶稣就问了一个问题。
From whom do the kings of the earth and the custom take the customs or taxes?From the sons or from the strangers? Peter said to him, From strangers. Jesus said to him, Then the sons are free. Nevertheless, we offend them. Go, now he knows what to do, look. Go, what to do? Go to the sea, cast the hook, and take the fish that come up first. Don't stay there longer. Don't fish longer. Just take one fish. And when you open its mouth, you will find a piece of corn.Take it and give it to them for me and for you.
马太福音十七章二十四到二十七节啊，这个简单来说就是耶稣啊，彼得问耶稣， 耶稣问说世上的君王向谁征收关税丁税，是向自己的儿子呢，是向外人呢？彼得说是向外人。耶稣说既然如此，儿子就可以免税了。所以呢，耶稣在这个时候，因为他有智慧的灵，所以他知道该怎么办，然后他就告诉彼得去海边去钓鱼，然后这个钓到的鱼然后张开他的口就能够得到钱，这个钱就作为那个税银。
Amen.
Amen.
Now the second thing was Jesus was tried by the religious Pharisees and Sadducees, a religious circle, to trap him.
接下来这个例子就是在约翰福音八章三到七节里面，耶稣被那些法利赛人所就那试探。
So through the spirit of wisdom, he know what to do. He know where to speak, where to don't speak, and where to be silent.
因为耶稣有智慧的灵，所以他知道什么时候该说话，什么时候该沉默。
So the spirit of wisdom is necessary to discern situation.
所以智慧的灵可以帮助你来去辨别各种各样的环境和情况。
You can discern this entire situation by the spirit of wisdom.
靠着智慧的灵，你就可以去分辨各种情况。
What is true, what is false?
什么是真的，什么是假的
？That was in the life of Jesus, John chapter 3.
所以，
John chapter 8.
对，这个就是耶稣他的故事。约翰福音八章三到七节。
When the woman was caught in the act of the adultery, they say.
就当那个行淫的妇人被抓过来的时候。
They didn't bring the man.Just women.
他没把那个男的抓来，他把这个。
So it tells you they want to trap him.
就是意思就是他们想要把他给杀了。
Because if they all come and bring them both of them and both they were stoned.
因为这个在律法当中，两个人都要被用石头打死。
But they want to trap Jesus, but the spirit inside of the Lord, the spirit of wisdom was resting inside of him. He can discern the situation.
他们这个法利赛人他做这个就是为了来去陷害耶稣嘛，所以耶稣有智慧的灵，所以他能够去辨别分辨他们的动机和目的。
So he discerned the situation. He knew they were all sinful people.
他知道就是说他分辨，所以呢，他就知道他们所有人都是罪人。
He was writing something on the ground.
所以呢，所以耶稣他就沉默不语，在地上画字。
Yes, and then he stood up and he answered according to the rule.
这针对那个法利赛人给他就是设陷阱的这个问题，耶稣就站起来。
So as we are looking into the seven spirits of God, you can also see the rainbow.
当我们看到神的七灵，也是可以在这个彩虹当中看到。
It is one rainbow after the rain. It is one big rainbow.
雨后就你可以看见一条彩虹。
They are all one.
是
With seven different colors.
这个七个不同的颜色。
They are not seven scattered in the different directions. Seven different colors of rainbow.
七个不同的彩虹的颜色，它不是。纷乱的，或者
There's only one glorious rainbow on the sky.
所以呢，它是在天空当中有一条彩虹。
That's representation of the seven spirits of God.
所以它也是代表了神的七灵。
And if you can picture as well deeper into that, you know, there's difference between the word of wisdom that 1 Corinthians 12 verse 8 talk about and the spirit of wisdom.
在哥林多前书十二章八节里面，这个地方讲到智慧的言语，智慧的言语，然后和智慧的灵是有相似的地方，但又不一样。
The word of wisdom is like the thought, one thought, one person. It's like one thought only. The word of wisdom.
Thought.
Yes.
Okay. 这个智慧的言语就像是一个思想，或者是在这个屏幕上像那一小片拼图。
But the spirit of wisdom.
但是智慧的灵
It's like this vast of thoughts, the completeness of all the muscles.
智慧的灵是一个就是这种怎么说很广大的一个思想，然后好像是这个海洋一样。
The word of wisdom, it could be also pictures like your feet are splashing to touching the surface of the water.
你的这种智慧的言语就好像是你的脚在水里面这样踢水。
But the being filled with the spirit of wisdom, you are on the surfing board.
但如果你被智慧的灵充满
Vast oceans in and out, front, back and forward, unlimited. Fire of the Holy Ghost, spirit of wisdom, burning, shining through.
但如果你被智慧的灵充满，你就在
You're riding
在海上，然后来去冲浪
You're riding in the Holy Ghost.
然后你就随着这个圣灵的带领来去冲浪
Are you grasping this? Paul the Apostle prayed for the Ephesians as well that we Gentiles be filled with the Spirit of wisdom, beloved.
所以使徒保罗在以弗所书里讲到说，这个我亲爱的呀，你们要被圣灵充满。
Hallelujah. Paul was the apostle to the Gentiles, other nations than Jews. And he prayed that God of the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give to us the spirit of wisdom and revelation, understanding in the knowledge of God.
所以就是他祷告，就以弗所书第一章17节就讲到说，愿神，这个基督耶稣，我们荣耀的父赐给我们智慧和启示的灵，智慧知识的灵。
We must be hungry.
就是我们必须要渴望，我们渴慕智慧的灵。Understanding
revelation and the knowledge of God in our lives.
渴慕智慧和启示的灵。Then
we can look at God on His page. On His page.
以至于我们能够去与神达成共识。
On God's will. On God's side.
明白神的旨意。
So let us arise and pray.
让我们兴起祷告。
And ask.
寻求。
God of our Lord Jesus Christ.
寻求我们的主。
The Father of glory.
我们的主耶稣基督。
To give us the Spirit of wisdom.
荣耀的父赐给我们智慧的灵。
Let's pray. 祷告。
让我们祷告。
Can we arise? I will conclude that message.
好，我来总结我今天所讲的。
If you desire, the first thing you have to desire that spirit of wisdom.
首先你要渴慕智慧的灵。
If you don't desire as a man,
如果你
you will not get.
如果你不渴慕，你得不着。
You have to desire.
你首先要
As a mother, you have to desire spirit of wisdom so you can know how to raise the child.
所以作为妈妈，你要渴慕智慧的灵，以至于你知道如何养育你的。
And your child, the one child, it is not like second child or the third child. They are all different children.
你虽然有不同的孩子，可是你的每一个孩子都是不一样。
A same mother giving birth to totally different children.
同一个妈妈生的孩子，每个孩子都不一样。
And they all behave differently.
他们的行为也不一样。
That is why the mother must be filled with the spirit of wisdom and she can know how to navigate and how to deal and how to raise those every different individual children.
所以妈妈们要被智慧的灵充满，以至于你知道该如何养育你的每一个孩子。
For the pastor, he needs to be filled with the spirit of wisdom so he can know his sheep, walk his sheep in the sheepfold exactly need.
那牧师也要被智慧的灵充满，以至于他知道他所牧养的群羊的具体的每一个需要。
How to advise them on the right decision?